bring everything but the hog out. Think we eat nothing but grass, what you talking about? I'm about to jump into the whip and hit the Whole Foods early. Get everything to get that soul food peas and get a roast of that tofu turkey. Got cornbread, even got stuff. Mashed potatoes so good, put your hands in it. Green beans and you know we got yams with it.
Welcome back, all you beautiful souls, spreading compassion and the tofu cube of truth all around the world. This is actually Tuesday night on the 25th of February. I do believe that's right. Is it? Yeah, I think so. So tomorrow, Wednesday, I'm actually going with the animal liberation truck with my friend Alan. We're actually going to pick two cows up from Strathclyde here in Scotland, and we're taking them down to a sanctuary down in England. So I'm going to take you all through this journey. I hope to show you some great, great little memories. Let's see what this takes us. Like I say, these are the kind of things that really save animals, guys. You do a lot of activism, but there doesn't take anything that, the pleasure it gets when you actually see an animal getting taken from a farmed environment into a sanctuary to live its life out with peace, freedom, just the way they actually should be. The same thing that me and you desire, and the thing that we're granted from the day we were born, which is the moral basic right to life and obviously freedom as well, guys. Obviously there's a lot of countries out there that don't have that luxury, and that's really, really sad, guys, because we should all have that basic moral right. Like I say, every being should live in peace and freedom and be able to have the basic moral right of life. So I hope to show you a lot of good footage, guys. I'm just going to go and crash in and get up early in the morning because I'll need to leave here roughly about 7 o'clock. It's a 45 minute journey here from where I'm actually going to get picked up by Alan at Straven and here in Scotland, guys. So I've got this big guy sitting here watching over me. Aren't you fudgy boy? So guys, I'll speak to you all very, very soon and we'll see where this takes us. Let's hope it's a good one. These sanctuary journeys and rescues, they're never easy, but yeah, we've just got to try our best. So you just expect the unexpected, is the same, guys. So let's speak all soon. Guys, that's me just at Straven Park waiting for Alan. The truck's actually broke down, so I'll speak to you in a little minute, but look at how lovely this park is. It's absolutely adorable. Lovely crisp sunshine in this time of year here in Scotland, which is absolutely amazing considering it's February. I don't know if that's a good thing. I think climate change has got a very big part to play in this. Basically because we're grazing animals for food consumption, this is what's causing all the climate change, guys, and we've got literally 12 years to do something about it, or 11 years I should say. 2030, scientists are warning us. So yeah, just look at this little stream here and everything. Lovely. How adorable is that? Really amazing. Lovely, lovely park. Just look at this, it's absolutely lovely. Amazing. Really great little scenery you have here in Scotland. Some of the parks are absolutely adorable, guys, they really are. You can see there up the top of the hill, don't know if you can see them, little dogs running about as well. This park is absolutely full of dogs, so yeah, absolutely lovely, lovely weather. So I'm just going to have a wee sit down and have a wee chat with you guys. So guys, my nerves are absolutely rattled, as we would hear say here in Scotland. As coming through New Mills, coming to Straven, where I was actually meeting Alan, this truck actually traversed right over the side of the road, or traversed I should say. See, I can't even get my words out because my nerves are absolutely jangling. What actually happened was he actually crossed right over the other side of the road. I actually had to swerve and go into a bush, and I thought my life had just flashed before my eyes. I was absolutely shooken. So the driver got out, he said he'd been driving for 16 hours, which I actually thought was pretty illegal, I would have reckoned, because I do believe that they've got to stop every 8 hours, I think it's for a 45 minute break. So he had been saying that he'd been travelling for 16 hours, so that is really unsafe, but he said that he didn't see the corner until the last second. And obviously he got out and he said he took full responsibility for what happened. He asked me if I wanted the police to come out, but luckily enough I wasn't injured, the car wasn't in bad damage either, nothing happened to the car because it was flat ground that I actually went through and it was just a bush, so it was just muck all over the car, so luckily enough that. So he gave me his details to give to the insurance and things like that if I want to proceed with that, so good that he at least understood. But wow, it's unbelievable, that's what I say, you just can never tell the moment, like I say, tomorrow's never given, as the same goes. But and then I just got here, and then Alan has actually just messaged me to say that part of the battery has actually come away from the truck, so he's actually stranded on the M80. So the insurance company is coming out and they're sending one of the mechanics out to try and fix it at the roadside. Failing that, it will be towed home to Alan's home, and then the rescue will be obviously cancelled, guys. So this is what happens, this is the side of rescues that you don't obviously see, so we'll just see how this goes, guys, and if I manage to get more footage and show you more of what happens today, I will. If it's cancelled to next time, we'll just continue on for here, but this is the glamorous side of animal rescue. You just never know the moment, it never seems to go easy, but hey ho, you've just got to try your best. So guys, welcome back. Just to let you know all about what happened yesterday. Basically, the rescue didn't go to plan. The woman that was actually owning the animals, and I use owning in the definitive term, because you know what I mean, the animals are not owned, they're not property, but what she actually did was she wouldn't let us take the animals on a technicality, guys. So these kind of things happen quite a lot. You've just got to do it the best you possibly can. So it's all about licenses and things like that. She was wanting an animal care and handling license, and obviously a license to obviously transport the animals, which Alan is actually looking into. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm actually going to start showing you every single month. I'm going to show you how I'm doing at the gym. So as you know, I've been doing a lot of strength training lately. I'm actually a qualified personal trainer as well, so I'm obviously trying to build myself up, guys. So as you can see, this is my laptop screen here. This is all the things that's going on in the background. I'm not showing you that, but I'm going to just show you actually what I'm doing and a little talk over what's actually going on there, guys. So yeah, let's do this. As you can see there, that's me flexing the muscles. Right here, what we're actually doing is we're actually doing deadlifts. This is actually at 70 kilograms for 3 sets of 10. Form's looking quite good, I would say. Probably need to flex those, or I should say strengthen those glutes a bit more, and obviously make sure that I've got what I would say is a piece of paper between both arms, so I need to be a little bit better on the form, but coming along nicely, I would say. Here we're actually doing bicep curls, 3 sets of 10. This is at 12.5 kilograms, so 25 kilograms in total. I could probably slow down the movement a bit on the descent, I would say. But apart from that, really, really good. I'm quite happy with that. Captain America there. So this is lat pull downs, 3 sets of 10, and that was at 40 kilograms, so quite good form there. That is, I'm using a wide grip as well, which is really, really good. It strengthens those lats as well, so looking good on the form, I would say. Obviously, I would say as well, guys, if you are doing pull-ups, the good thing that you want to start doing is inverted rows. It really strengthens your lats as well, and obviously travels over back into your pull-ups. So here we're doing renegade rows. This is again 12.5 kilograms for 3 sets of 10. You always make sure that you're actually staying steady, your body's not rocking from side to side, because you see a lot of people in the gym doing that, guys. So that's what you want to do. You want to keep your, tighten your core, make sure your back's straight and you're not swaying from side to side. Here I'm actually doing bench press. This is 45 kilograms. A bit rough there, I would say, but yeah, one of the bad reps to start with. Obviously, I usually have quite an arch in my back as well, guys, and that's one thing that I really should stress that you do. Here, I'm not actually got that arch in my back, so this is why I always like to film myself, to look back and actually see where I've went wrong, if I have done. Because I'm a personal trainer, I can see other people making mistakes, but sometimes it's hard yourself. One thing I would say there, make sure that you come all the way back to the bar and when you're re-racking it, because you can obviously hurt yourself and it can fall on you, so don't do that. Squats are always a big problem for me, obviously, because I've got sciatic nerve damage and I've obviously got a dropped left foot. But what you really want to do in front squats is keep your elbows high. I find sometimes it's really, really difficult for me, and you can see it there, elbows are a bit of an issue, but getting depth, it's all about working on it. Like I say, I used to be able to do this very, very easily, about 120 kilograms. So here we're actually doing pushdowns, as you can see, guys. So this is 3 sets of 10. Obviously at 40 kilograms, making sure that you obviously lock out at the bottom, which is really, really important to get the full range of motion. Me having a little bit look around the gym there. Who's watching me? Paranoia. Here we're obviously doing dumbbell overhead press at 12.5 kilograms, 3 sets of 10. Obviously make sure you get full range of motion as well, and obviously lock out at the top. It's not the best of angles there, but I'm definitely doing that. And just a little flex for you, extreme annoying vegan. Here we go, this is actually at, what was that, 25.50. That was at 100 kilograms for one rep, which is really, really good, so I'm quite happy with that. This was just a little light session at 40 kilograms. Probably could do a bit better in the range of motion there, but yeah, you've just got to push along and accept the good and bad days, I suppose. This was a day I was really, really struggling with a lot of gut issues as well, guys, so which I have been for the last few weeks. I'm obviously getting that investigated by Goji Man very, very soon. I'll give you a little update on that. This is obviously chest flies, which is 30 kilograms that was at. So obviously making sure you get the full range of motion is really, really important, and you obviously make sure that you obviously do that is really, really important, guys. So oh, look at me. Wow. Oh, sometimes I embarrass myself, but obviously back to the Renegade Rose, this was 10 kilograms. Could have done a little bit better there, I thought. I see a little bit of a swaying movement, which is a bit of a worry. But like I say, this was when I was actually suffering with the gut issues as well, guys. So I'm quite pleased with the overall progress. I've made a massive progress this last, I would say, good 6 months. So let me know in the comments down below if you've obviously seen a big improvement, or if you haven't seen an improvement, what would you like me to improve on? I'll take criticism as well, guys, because I'm open to growing, so I'm only here to try and spread positivity and obviously help other people as well. Using that spidey pillars here, this was at 10 kilograms, so like I say, I went a bit lighter. I went for a deload this past week, so that's really, really important, because I've been obviously hitting it hard for the last 6 months, guys, so you've got to do a little deload now and then. It's really, really important you do that. Actually slowing down a bit as well, that was a bit fast there. This was 70 kilograms, like I say, back down for a little bit of deload on that. I would like to have my chest more lower to my knees, that's really, really important. I can see that has been a bit of an issue there, and obviously the knee coming in a little bit on the right hand side, which is a bit of a worry, but otherwise really, really good. And a little bit of a look at the camera there for you. Everybody in the gym looking at me like, what's he doing? What's he filming about? Crazy vegan. And somebody just photobombing there with a walkout through the camera. This was 30 kilograms. Try to keep those elbows a little bit higher there, which is really, I'm quite pleased with that. As you can see, I'm trying to correct it there a little bit. Good depth there, I'm pleased with that one. And again. And again. Quite pleased with that there. Yeah, if I can keep getting that and keeping the elbows higher, I'd be quite happy with that. So I'm going to show you a little bit that I actually done hip thrusts. These were 50 kilograms. Quite pleased with these guys. They're always really, really tough, but you know, you've got to get those good glutes working. Show off that posterior. Wearing the old Reebok pumps there as well, guys. Doing a little bit of flashback to the 90s for you all. 80s child here. No millennial. And a little bit of posing for last night. Just look at the difference in the body physique. It's really, really good. Fudge photobombing me as well, guys. So remember, as always, veganism is based on three positives. Go vegan. Vegan for the animals. Vegan for the health. Vegan for the planet. Someday they won't be laughing. That's really, really important. So I hope you like this, guys. Remember, as always, if you want me to do a little bit of these every single month, showing you some workouts and obviously a physique update, I would love to do that, guys. I hope you have liked this little vlog style, and I would love to do more of these types. Remember, as always, binge on life, purge negativity and starve guilty feelings, and be kind to every kind. The only difference is your perception, and I'll speak to you on the next video. Binge on life, purge negativity and starve guilty feelings. Speak to you all soon and love you so much.